Hello, Nimaita.
Yes, we can start now. No issue.
Because time is already over. So number of participants almost near about 50.
Yes, we can start.
So very good morning, all of you. So as you know, today is the third session of the consecutive 3 days special session. We have completed our first day, day one, on Mendeley by Dr. Shahbaz Nauseen, day two on EndNote by Dr. Sujit Kujur, and today is our last day. The today's topic is, as you know, according to our circular, the LS Discovery Service. So this is for your kind information that, so last couple of few years, basically 6 or 7 years, we are habituated and used to our Discovery Service as well as the remote access service through Open Athens by EBSCO. So we are very habituated and this package are very familiar to our community too. And this particular remote access by EBSCO and Open Athens, it was last day, lasting today. From tomorrow, the platform will be changed from EBSCO to LIPSIS by LS Discovery. So this is our challenge too. So hope we are enriching today special session by Saxena ji. So before going to our deliberation, I am introducing the today's speaker, Dr. Deepak Saxena. You are mostly welcome. So he's the business manager of LS Discovery Solution, associated with the LIPSIS for more than 20 years. And instrumental, his specialization of work is instrumental in research, conceptualization, design, and development of the LS Discovery. So before going to the deliberation today by the Saxena ji, may I request our honorable university librarian, Dr. Nimai Chand Saha, for few comments and introductory lecture. Nimaita, please.
Thank you, Kaushik. Very good morning, one and all. And at the very outset, let me just warm welcome to our today's, I cannot say speaker, I cannot say resource person, but one of the active member of Biswabharati Library Network since 98 onwards until the date, we found that Dr. Deepak Saxena was in LIPSIS, is in LIPSIS, will be in LIPSIS, was in Biswabharati Library, is in Biswabharati Library, and will be at the Biswabharati Library with his ever active support. And today, his shirt color is light green, but I think he is deep green with his mentality to extend his cordial support for the Biswabharati Library network. And you see, without any hesitation, being the librarian of this university, I would like to extend an words for LIPSIS team people, including Dr. Saxena and Samiran from Calcutta, and there are many members. Some of them have directly contacted Biswabharati and some may not, but they are doing this work in a team platform. So we are really grateful to them over the last 20 years for their zero gap service. Whenever we ask something, they are 24/7 ready to extend our support. And as a part of that, just last Friday, I have a request from my side that you people asking 48 hours working day, my system will be off. Can you please do work on Saturday and I can give you Saturday so that it will be coming up? Without thinking twice, the representative told us, okay, sir, we'll do it. So that's why we are coming Monday onwards. Still the platform is in experimental basis and all their team members is working 24/7 mode to excel their service for Biswabharati Library users. And this Saxena ji is the basic backbone of our platform developer, and whatever we are asking, he is taking care with his team member. In spite of his busy and tight schedule for us to develop the platform, he is kind enough to deliver his showcase this platform, how to use, because we are not so aware how to use it. we are just going to learn something, Dr. Saxena, along with our teammates, along with our users, that how this LS discovery we will expedite in our future course of academic activities. And you see, rightly Dr. Kousik was noted that last 8 to 10 years we are using discovery services through Open Athens platform. The vendor was EBSCO Discovery. And you see, whenever we using any platform, sometimes we are have some weaker side or soft side on that particular platform. But I can rest assured you all, faculty members, scholars, officers, students, that this LS Discovery is much more easier, simpler to retrieve our target resources. And this is for the first time when Vishwavidyalaya Library Network is going to showcase its services into real 24/7 modes from anywhere by using any network, by using any device, anyone, regardless of their categorical structure at Vishwabharati. Because that earlier remote access discovery through Open Athens, it was extended till 500 members, particularly for scholars and faculty members. But this time, we have no boundary. All of my UG students, all of my class 12 students, to my Vishwabharati pensioners, those who are the member of this library, having library card, they will be entitled to surf our library resources through a single window. And through that window, everyone will get the accessibility of e-resources and digitized resources. What is the basic difference in between e-resources and digitized resources? Means e-resources is the documents which are by bond soft copy, and digitized resources, which was earlier in print mode, now to preserve the cultural horizon of Indian culture and other academic aesthetics, we just need to digitize the print books and to make it available in the platform. Earlier it was through digital library means DSpace, and now this is a umbrella platform, amalgamated platform, LS Discovery, where you will not get to open a second window, just a single window. You just type a particular keywords or your required terms. It will showcase whether it is available in the thesis, whether it is available in the print books, whether it is available in the digitized book, whether it is available in the electronic books, be it question paper, be it syllabus, and of course, be it in the faculty publications. So all these things, they bring together in a single umbrella. And this single umbrella, whenever you just take into login, and Dr. Saxena will elaborate these things technically and literally very elaborately. And today he is here for us. After his deliberation, without taking his permission, I, on behalf of Dr. Saxena, give you blank check to ask question, to interact with him by chat box or by audio voice. He will be kind enough to exemplify us, to enlighten us how to proceed these things, because Lipsis is one of the best Indian entrepreneurs who is not only doing business for a rupee, but also to cater the academic excellence, but also to cater the research activity, to develop the research activities. And as you understood from the prefix of Dr. Saxena, he is also academics. He has already done his PhD work. So he's working there, we are working here, but I don't found any difference. He is also a man of academics. That is why he's catering academic service to us. So with these few words, let us listen how this LS Discovery from tomorrow onwards will be available for us. And I'm sure another 7 to 10 days may require to enrich our platform with all sorts of resources. But tomorrow onwards, it will be handed over to us. Yes, our library website also will be available in this platform. So it is a single basket where Vishwavidyalaya Library Network will be available through this single window, single click, and all other things. So with these few words, let me invite with our sincere regards to one of the extended member of Vishwavidyalaya family in general and Vishwavidyalaya Library Network family members in particular, Dr. Saxena. Please welcome, and let me hand over the platform to you. Now time for you. Please take care about this session. Thank you, Dr. Saxena.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thanks for your kind words. It's a privilege to work with you. We are working together for almost over, I think, 20 years. Right. And We are basically, I can say, your technology partners in giving automation solutions to your library.
Right.
So let me share my screen and take you to the discovery platform. Hope my screen is visible.
Yes, you may proceed. Yes.
Yeah. Basically, let me take you through the discovery platform. When we say discovery, basically, the main USP of discovery is the OneSearch. OneSearch opens the digital front door to your library resources and beyond. It offers a single search box that taps into a wide range of materials, like your library catalog, journal, newspaper articles, ebooks, databases, and much more. You can include digital repositories like your DSpace in OneSearch. You can search across library resources in a single search interface, verify citations, find articles from subscribed electronic journals, conduct an interdisciplinary search to find items inside and outside your area of expertise. So what you are seeing on the screen is the landing page of discovery. You'll have many features over here. I'll explain you one by one. First, let me show you the OneSearch. OneSearch basically, as the name says, like it's all about search. We have two types of search over here, basic search and the combination search. Basic search is the simple search where you type your keywords and search. It gives you option to choose the resource type for your search, like all general articles, ebooks, library collection, digital repository. So let me take you through one of the examples how we make a simple search. For example, let's try artificial intelligence. So as you keep typing, system comes up with the search suggestion box. We call this as suggestion list. So you can pick up your keywords from the suggestion list itself. You can choose by default, it will show you any field. As a user, I can choose the field where I would like to search. Like in full text, I want to search author, journal name, publisher, series, subject, and many fields available. You can choose the resource type, like you want to search in all the resources. You want to search in general articles, ebooks, library collection, or any other digital repository. Let's try with the all. So basically, when you search, basically, it goes to different resources, search and retrieve your information. You have basically choice of choosing the resource types, like all, general article, ebooks, library collection. You'll have the option to choose view the new arrivals. New arrivals basically, like it's coming from your LMS, that is your library catalog, collection of newly added books. You can view this. You can also check the new arrivals for the journals like this. These new arrivals can be viewed by title or by author, like this. Even I can view the new book summary, like on which subject, how many new editions are available, like this. Then we have the option, we can view the popular books. Basically, these popular books are based on the data of LMS, like how a library is using, users are using the resources of library. Based on that, system populates this information about popular books. For example, we'll just check the first entry. Here you can see the more information about the this particular book, Coding Theorems, written by Parthasarathy K.R. You can display this information in linear format, MARC format, or you can even opt for ACR2 format. Then you have a choice to read the reviews. There are basically two kinds of reviews available. One review you can see of your colleague or maybe your fellow student who has written the review. Another one review will come from goodreads.com. And as a user, I can also submit my review on this particular title. Then you have more books by author. That means like if I'm interested to find if there are more books written by Parthasarathy K.R. author and available in my library, I can choose more book by author. So you can see there are multiple titles available in the library written by Parthasarathy K.R. Then we have the shelf browse, where you will have a feel how books would be arranged on the shelf. This is basically a kind of a virtual shelf, which you can see on the screen. And also you can see the location of the book and the accession number. And from here itself, you can add to the cart. Then there's a place where a library would be putting some important information, and you can read the information available. Then some figures are coming. This basically figures are about the number of records indexed in the library, books and journals. Then we have the feature to browse the subjects. Like these basically, again, the subject would be categorized by the library staff. And as a user, you can basically explore the collection, explore the titles, items available under these different subjects, like agriculture, archaeology, architecture. And then we have an option where you can subscribe to RSS feeds. RSS feeds, basically, you can subscribe for new editions. That is, whatever the new books are added in the library, you can basically subscribe to that feed, and you can get, you can download those books in any standard RSS reader. Then we have a feed for SDI, where a user can, you know, choose the subscription for SDI service of his choice. So this was about the RSS. Further, you have a choice, like you can see a list of e-libraries, free, where like open access of free e-libraries are available. Again, these links basically would be changed according to the requirement of the users and requirement of the library. I'm just giving you an example, like there will be links available which user can explore. Feedback, basically, as a user, if you want to submit some feedback, this is the place you can submit feedback on the services or on the application interfaces. And this feedback would be received by the library staff, and they can further, you know, respond back to the feedback. And there are further links for some audio books or some other resources which are available on the web. So again, these links would be updated, modified, customized based on how there's a demand by the community. Then another important aspect here is the notification. Now, basically, this notification is from the library system. So it shows how many books you have currently taken Like in my case, there are 12 books available, 2 loose issues, 2 bound journals, and there are about 2 interlibrary loan journals available, and about 90 rupees fine is pending on my account. And you're seeing like overdue 12, something in red color. This red color means these books are already overdue. That means they have crossed the time when I'm supposed to return these books back to the library. So this is basically the notification panel, all important notification from library with respect to your transactions, your account, your reservation status, your fines would be published in this area. You can further see the library timings from here. The rules and regulations are available. And of course, the GPS location of your library would be displayed over here. So basically, this is the basic interface for discovery. Let's try with the search. Then you have basically the A to Z list. A to Z list basically is the standard list which basically provides list of electronic journals that the library has the access. The list can be browsed by a discipline and by publisher. For example, let's say aging. There are 4 titles on aging. And if I click on the title, it takes me to the home page of that particular journal which I have selected. Like this. Let's say try with the aging clinical and experimental research. Like this. And then we have a choice. We can browse the A to Z list by publisher. Let's say I am interested in finding journals by AIP Publishing. These are a list of all the journals that are subscribed from AIP Publishing. And let's say I want to go through the issues of applied physics letter. I'll just click on this. Now here you can explore all the latest issues and also the previous issues of the EIP journal. Likewise, you can click on any other journal, let's say low temperature physics. You can basically explore in the different issues. Like we have issue of 3rd March. Likewise, physics today. Just select on any title and it takes you to the home page of the journal. And from there, you can basically explore. This was basically by publisher. This is how basically you're going to use the A to Z list. Then, you can see there's a place where you can click and you can log into your account. After login, basically what you will see on the screen is the dashboard. This dashboard basically is a wonderful tool for patrons to monitor their library usage. It displays most of important metrics at a glance, like your late fee, your recommendations, transactions, your login status, and all important notifications. Here you can see there's a place where system is displaying the card. Card basically is the place where you have saved all your favorite records. Fee log, the amount which you already paid and fine which you are supposed to pay. Then recommendation, basically if you are allowed by the libraries, you can suggest some titles, some books, some ebooks to the library. And you can see like what action they have taken on that. You can see how many transactions you have done in the library today on a weekly basis, on a monthly. You can see a kind of a count of your transactions which you have done in the library current date on a weekly basis or a monthly basis. Then also you can go through the notification, all the important messages that library has to offer you. Then we comes to items. Basically, item option provides list of books taken by the user, the checkout history, reservation, and option to renew the books. Now, first one is the items checkout. Basically, this will show you the books which you have already taken into your account. And there's a place where you can, you know, renew the books. You can check the items history. Item history, basically, let's say if you are the member of the library for, let's say, 4 years, 3 years, 2 years, you can see what all books you have taken so far. Basically kind of your history records of your transactions done by the library in items history. Then you have basically the reserves. Reserves basically is like the books which you have reserved. And even you can cancel the reservations online. Then you have the late fee log where you can check how much fine is pending in your account, how much fine you already paid. And like if like there's an option where you can make online payment also using this pay option. Then comes to recommendation. Recommendation basically is a place where you can use this feature to recommend books, serials, articles, or newspaper subscription for the library, and you can even check the status of your request, you know, online. Like you can see, like the first one is requested, request number is B48 and the status is requested. So that means you have submitted the request and so far library will work on these requests. For adding a new request, you can click on add recommendation. Now this is the basically a small form where which you can submit for recommendation. You can choose whether you are recommending for books, for journals, or for articles. Let's try one book. If you know the ISBN, you can simply key in the ISBN. And let's say if you are not aware of the ISBN, what you can do, you can simply, you know, type a few words of the title. Let's say, for example, I'm trying Linux admin, and just click search on web. So it searches basically the Google Books, Amazon Books, and you know, give you titles that are on Linux administration. For example, let's say I'm interested in getting this Linux administration handbook. Just select. So system gonna, you know, populate the field automatically for you, so that you submit this request to the library staff. Likewise, you can recommend journals, write the ISSN number, title the journal that you would like to request. Then the place where you can request for new articles, just key in the title of the article and the source, like from where it is likely to be made available. Then we comes to my questions. This is the place where your queries would be answered online. If you have any questions, any doubts or any queries, you can simply, you know, use my question section where you can submit your post your question and get the response from the library staff. And if you have already posted your question, this is the place where you can check the response. For example, like the first one, then status is not replied, not replied. And if you see third one is already replied. If it's already replied, you can simply click and check the response, what response is given by the library. For adding a new questions, just click on add questions and fill this form. Fill this form and submit. This question will be submitted to the library staff and they will respond back. Then there's a place like, in case as a user, if you would like to donate some of your used books or some other resources to the library, this is the place where you can, you know, fill up this form and submit for the library staff. They will review your request and then they will notify you whether the donation which you're planning to give to the library can be taken or not taken. So this is basically for donations. Next one basically is your login session history. Basically here you can check like your activity, what all you have done with the discovery. You can see like from where you have logged in, and even system basically, you know, keeps track of your entire session. For example, let's say if I want to see the details. So what all you have, done, it will be displayed over here like this. Then basically it's a place where you can, you know, see your card and you can basically download your card in different format. Card basically is a kind of a basket where you can save your citations or book records, and you can later you can download in PDF format, Excel, HTML. Then there's a place where you can check your profile, your account, like you can put your personal information, which basically using which you have logged in the system would be available. You can change your password. You can change your password using this change password option. There's an option where you can choose the color themes for discovery. Like for example, currently the theme which is used is the green color shade. Like let's say if you would like to choose a blue color, you can choose the blue color theme or the red color themes. There'll be more themes available as per the requirement. As we keep updating the discovery, we'll add more themes. So currently, like we have configured with three themes: so red color, blue color, and the green color. Next one again is a quite interesting feature, statistics. Now, as a basically, this is feature is useful for especially for the librarians and the departmental heads. Like as a departmental head, if you would like to explore like how your department or your e-subscribed e-sources are utilized in practical terms. So let me take you through the statistics. Usually, e-sources uses statistics contains a wealth of information, but mining that information from the massive amount of data can be time consuming and very difficult. But discovery statistic function focuses on the practical aspects of getting the data quite easy and user friendly. Lipsis discovery basically gives you option to choose your department. Department might be as managed by your library staff in your membership report. You can view e-resource usage of your department month-wise, year-wise, publisher-wise in a very simple yet informative format with the graphical representation. So let me just show you one example like how these stats work. For example, let's say I'm a user, I'm basically heading the agribusiness management department. So on the left-hand side, you can see a list of all subscribed resources. And right-hand side, you can see the usage year-wise. And now let's take one step further. When I say like year-wise, basically this count basically is nothing but the downloads done by the users of agribusiness management department. Now, let's say I am quite interested to find how Applied Economics journal is used in my department. So what I'll do, I click on this Applied Economics journal. Now you can see the usage of this Applied Economics will be displayed instantly on my screen from 2011 until 2020. Now, you can see in 2019, the usage was quite good, 613. Now, I would like to see like how we have used journal in 2019. So just click on this blue triangle. Now you can see different years. Click on 2019. So system will show you the monthly breakup for 2019. Like you can see in December, November, October. Likewise, if you're interested in the 2018 year, like this. So just click and system will keep displaying you the statistics of that particular year. Likewise, let's say if you want to change the journal, let's say Applied Economic Letters. First step, it shows you all the years. Second step, you can choose the year for which you would like to see the usage. Basically, this usage will help you decide whether you want to renew or want to continue with a subscription for that particular journal in next year, next financial year or not. So unless you exactly know the usage, it will be difficult for you to decide how you would like to renew or you want to discontinue with that particular subscription. This was basically for a particular department. Now, second option we have, like you can basically, check like the usage from different publishers. For example, let's say Oxford Journals. So how Oxford Journals you have utilized, you can check for that. Let's say Springer Journals like this. And our concept is same basically, like for a particular resource, just click on that resource and system will show you the usage of that particular resource. And next step, click on year-wise to find the year-wise breakup. Let's say Taylor and Francis, like this. Wiley Journals, like this. So basically, this statistics interface basically is created keeping in mind, like usually people find it very difficult, you know, to analyze, understand the statistics, because the data which is available from different publishers is in quite raw format. So it's all kind of, you know, dump CSV files. So you have to just scan, analyze each and every CSV file and then compile something meaningful. Whereas like Discovery, you know, translate that data into a very simple but useful interface for finding the statistics of your electronic resources usage. Then basically we have the saved searches, where you can basically, you know, go through the searches which you have saved. You can retrieve, you can save your favorite searches, and you can retrieve anytime you would like to retrieve. So this was basically, you know, part of your login based services. Like the main advantage here, like it's fully integrated with your activities in the library. So whatever you do in the library, that is the transaction, you issue a checkout a book, you return a book, you renew a book, reserve a book, pay a fine, everything basically will be tracked by Discovery, and you can basically check your status on just single dashboard, and there is no need to, you know, log into different sources to find, or you don't have to inquire the library staff about your usage. You can do it instantly by logging on to our Discovery portal. So basically, I have to just show you the search, and for showing the search, I just have to, you know, change the link. Just give me 1 or 2 minutes. I'm just stopping screen share, and I'll just share my screen in just 2 minutes. In I think that 2-3 minutes, so maybe Dr. Nimai can you know, share something on this, so that I'll before after that I'll just show you the search. I'm just stopping the screen for a couple of minutes. Nimai sir, you can continue.
Hello, Nimai there. Hello.
Ah. Hello. Hello. Hello.
So Saxena ji has already completed his online demonstration.
Okay. So then it should be open for
interaction.
Yes. Yes.
So may I request all the participants please submit your query through chat box either or ask directly to the Saxena ji. You are all welcome. This is the time for interaction. So I have a question, but my question at the last. So all the participants, may I request to submit your query, because from tomorrow, this is our new platform.
Hello, Kaushik. Hello, Kaushik.
Yes. So আমরা কি ইন্টারঅ্যাকশন রাখতে পারি এখন?
হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ ইন্টারঅ্যাকশন রাখতে পারো, ইন্টারঅ্যাকশন
রাখো। সো শুন না, সো আই হ্যাভ এ কোশ্চেন সাকসেনা জি। সো ফার্স্ট অফ অল থ্যাংক ইউ ফর ইওর ফার্স্ট পেজ অফ দা ডেমোনস্ট্রেশন।
Yes sir.
সো রিগার্ডিং দা সার্চিং অপশন, অ্যাজ ইউ নো উই আর শোয়িং দ্যাট দেয়ার আর ডিফারেন্ট কাইন্ডস অফ সার্চিং লাইক অল জার্নাল আর্টিকেল, ই-বুক, লাইব্রেরি কালেকশন, ডিজিটাল রিপোজিটরি অলসো।
Yes, sir.
So this is for your kind of information that we have a lot of online databases. Few
yes,
online databases we have subscribed directly, and few online databases accessible through the ESS. Like the few online databases which is available from the ESS, just like ISID, JCC, MathSciNet, Web of Science, this one. And apart from these, we have subscribed few online databases on subscription basis and as well as the perpetual mode also. Yes, like Indiastat, like the EPWRF and few secret files from the worldware to oldware, which is available from the Taylor and Francis, and one another perpetual mode online databases like China and Hong Kong, etc. Those are provided by the Sengel. So my request to you that apart from these search engines like journal article, like ebook, like library collection, like digital repository, if we introduce another search engine for the online databases.
Fine, sir. Fine. Right now,
so it will be helpful for our client.
Sure, sir. We can basically add one more item as the online databases. That's fine.
And another point I have to add that more than 7,000 e-resources, which is available from the more than 7,000 e-journal, which is available from the ESS.
Yes, sir.
So in case of Open Athens, which is familiar by our client, that yes, all the e-resources basket is available according to the publisher wise. So if we click the Oxford University, the journal article which is available by the Oxford is available. If we click the JSTOR, if we click the Sengel, if we click the IOP, and if we click the Taylor & Francis, in such a way, it is better for us and better for the client. In case of remote access, if the e-resources is available publisher wise.
Okay, sir, fine.
So this is my two points and observation also.
So basically what you are saying that is taken care in the A to Z list. A to Z list basically is the listing by subject and by publisher.
Sure.
So you can just select the publisher and see the list of resources available from that publisher.
No, actually I watch, but challenge that within few days we have to incorporate all the e-resources in this basket.
So I think most of the e-resources are already there. Once I think the URL which you will be accessing, you can check there.
Few like not yet incorporate. Hopefully within few days.
Yes, sir. Because I think some we are fine tuning the DNS configuration.
Sure.
So because everything is shifted from different IPs to different IPs. So it takes some time to, you know, populate. Usually 24 to 48 hours it takes. So it's taking some time in that resolution. So otherwise, I think most of the things you already done. So sir, now I'm sharing my screen once more.
Okay.
So just take you through the search options. Sorry for, you know, stopping my screen. Now let's continue with my demonstration of discovery. Let me just show you the basic search. Like I select from the session list and I submit. Now, as soon as you submit, system, you know, fetches from the database and it comes up with a very simple screen. No complications, simple screen. Left hand side, you have all the filters. Filters, you know, basically are used to refine your search results. Right hand side, basically panel, you have the results with option to check the full text. So from here itself, I can modify my search and, you know, use different fields for searching. For example, let's say subject. So same artificial intelligence, I'm searching as a subject. So you can see our system comes up with the results instantly. Let's try with the journal name. Now you can see I'm getting about 3,500 hits on artificial intelligence as a journal name. Now let's try to use the filters. Now let me try the author filter. Now you can see first author set to give any. I want to see all the articles written by Seto Giovanni. Let's click. So now it has filtered out the author that are written by the author Sato Giovanni. Next, basically, let's say subject. I'm interested, in the subject law. So system has further fine-tuned the results by law. Let's try one more filter. Let's say by the journal name. Let's say Artificial Intelligence and Law Journal. Next, let's try the year. I'm interested only journals articles that are published from 2019 onwards. So you can see six. From 3,500, we have reduced our search results to just six records. This is basically how the filter works. Further, if I explain you the results, what we have got, you have basically the title, you have the author. These all authors are hyperlinked. That means like if I click on these authors, system will start displaying titles written by them. These all authors which are shown in blue color are hyperlinked. There's a place where you can have a quick preview. Let's say if I want to see quickly without going into details, I want to see a quick preview. Just click and system will show you more information about this article. That is the quick preview. Then we have an option, we can check the permanent link for this citation. I can download this citation. I can download this citation in BibTeX format, EndNote format, or Zotero format. I can even take the printout of the citation. I can email the citation to my email ID. Even there's an option, I can basically put this citation into my cart. Maybe if I would like to, review it later. Then there's an option you can basically click to retrieve the full text. Also, you can see the more details of this citation. From here itself also, you can check the permanent link, download citation, or email the citation. The results can be basically sorted based on the author, publisher in ascending format, publisher in descending format, and the title field. Another interesting feature which we have put over here, as a user, I would like to know more about this keyword artificial intelligence. Just click on this W icon. So what it does basically, it pick up the information about artificial intelligence from Wikipedia page, like this. And further, you can check what are related topics to artificial intelligence. So it shows you all the topics that are related to artificial intelligence as per Wikipedia. And further, if you click on read more, it takes you to the Wikipedia website like this, and it opens the artificial intelligence page for you. So this was about Wikipedia. And let me just show you the save icon. Basically, save icon basically is used to save your strategy for future use. So I've shown you in a dashboard where you can retrieve these saved searches. The next search basically is the combination search. Combination search basically allows you to perform more complex searches than a basic search. You can enter search term across a number of fields and combine criteria with Boolean operators. Let me show you one example of the combination search. Let's say I'm a user, I'm interested in finding Java in the title field. and I'll say I want to connect my fields as AND. Next, I'll say I'm interested to find software as the subject. And you are seeing here a plus sign. By clicking on plus, I can add more fields to my search strategy. For example, I click on plus, you can see one blank field has come. I click on another one, so another field has come. So I can basically keep adding as much as I want, basically, to, you know, make my search strategy more complicated, more comprehensive. So if I want to remove, I just click on minus. So again, let's say I use AND, and here I say I am interested in the author Roberts Eric. Choose here as author. So what I'm trying, basically, I'm trying to retrieve a title that basically got Java in them and software as a subject and Roberts Eric as the author. So again, I have a choice. I can choose like where I would like to search. So let me try with all, say search. I can see I have come up got a response of 5 records from the search which I have, you know, put. Again, I can choose the filters to fine tune my search. I can choose all other features that I have shown you just now, like downloading citation, emailing the results, checking the permanent link, or retrieving the full text. Now, I can modify my search. Let me just show you how I modify it. Now you can see this entry, resources to support the usage of Java in introductory computer science. So what I would do, I'll modify my search and make sure this computer science entry is not appearing in my results. So how I'll do it, I click on plus to add one more field. This time I'll say not, basically you can use AND or not. And here I'll say computer science. I'll say title and I choose exact match. If I submit this entry, Java in introductory computer science should get removed from the results. So same strategy, I'm just submitting again. Now you can see the 5 has become 4 and that computer science entry is removed from my output. So this is basically how you can use combination search for forming a complicated search strategies. So now one of, you know, the advantages of discovery is what basically we are pretty happy with the speed. Let me show you like how good is the speed. I'm just giving some wild keywords like science, which fetches a big number. And you can feel like how big numbers have come and how quickly system is, you know, coming up with the results. Let's say management. You can see how big figures, you know, system is retrieving. And the results are coming very fast. So another advantage which you will get basically is the speed. You will save a lot of time on your search because searches are pretty fast on a discovery platform. Like this. There's another search, citation search. This is basically maybe a new feature which might not be there in your old discovery solution. So this basically feature we made for, you know, advanced users. Like if you're particular, like want to retrieve articles from a particular journal, particular volume, particular issue, this is the place where, you know, you can directly hit the strategy. Let me just show you. Let's say I want to retrieve something from African arts. Just type the journal name, select from the list. System basically populates the ISSN automatically. Now let's say from African arts, I'm interested to retrieve articles that are written in the year 1968 under volume number 1, issue number 4. So as a user, like if you know exactly what you want, so this is the place we can directly, you know, submit your strategy by some inputting the name of the journal, year for which you want the articles, volume number and the issue number. So I just click. Now you can see system has retrieved all the records from the year 1968, volume number 1, issue number 4. From here itself, I can, you know, go for the full text of my choice. This is quite useful, like just by giving few fields, you will get you know, to download most of articles from particular journal of your choice. So this was basically the citation search. So one search I have shown you where you have choice of, you know, picking results from basic search or choose combination search. A to Z list, where the option you can explore resources based on the discipline, that is the subject or by, you know, publisher, and you can choose the citation search. And if you know the ISBN, let's say if you are just particular to find a book, ebook or anything, just, you know, key in the ISBN number and can straight away retrieve that entry. So this basically is about one search of discovery. So with this, I think my technical presentation is over. Now you can ask your questions. I'm just stopping the share. So if you have any query, any questions, you're most welcome to ask.
Kaushik, please take any questions from audience.
So actually, a few questions already submitted in the chat box.
That is not directly related to this LSD discovery, and I have already given answer.
So may I request all the participants, please submit your query or question related to this special session, basically the single window search, LSD discovery, how can we extract the resource from LSD discovery related to this. So all the questions are noted to the related. So what are the mandatories if I want to have a remote access of LSD discovery?
See, basically, so the last question, what are the mandatories if I want to have a remote access? Basically, you need to be an authorized user of Vishwati library. That's it. Like, if so, your credentials are authenticated, then you will get access to full text using, you know, LS discovery from any device of your choice.
So from the library, Vishwabharati library network, I'm answering this question that all the clients, you have to carry your user at library card. Vishwabharati library card is the only entry for discovery as well as the remote access. So your valid university library card is the mandatory feature.
Hello.
Please introduce yourself.
Good morning, sir. This is Anna from the social work department. Hello.
You may proceed, please.
Yes. Sir, actually, I got a little confused in one point. So now that I need to search articles from... So generally, I search articles from Sage and Taylor and Francis. So I would go to the option of journal. There I would write my key term. And so then I got lost. What exactly do I do next?
After that, you can filter on a publisher and you can choose the publisher, what you're saying, like Sage or whatever publisher you want. You can filter on the publisher. First step, basically, when search. Second, when the results are displayed, you can filter out on the publisher, or let's say if you are particular want to explore the articles or journals by the publisher, even you can go to A to Z list. From A to Z list, choose the publisher. The system will display a list of resources subscribed from that publisher. And then third step, you can choose the journal from where you would like to retrieve the articles.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome.
Hello, Mr. Saxena.
Yes, sir.
So whatever you explain, that are all online, e-books. But what about the hard copy books in our Vishwabharati library? How
sir,
can I...
Sir, when you are searching something, there's an option, library collection. When you choose library collection, it basically searches for the physical books. That is the physical books available in your libraries. While searching, just select library collection.
Okay.
May I ask the question? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, I'm Srivarna from Indian History Department, PhD scholar. My query is, when I search at the article, and if I get a full text, if I want to download it, like we used to do from other platforms, open text, so if I download it, will it be saved in the discovery platform, or it will come offline?
Ma'am, your voice is not very much clear, so I'm not able to hear your question.
Okay.
Not clearly audible. Otherwise, you may submit your question through chat.
Yeah, box. Chat box. You can.
Okay, sir.
Any more questions?
Few of the questions already submitted in the chat box, which is related to the access. So I have already informed earlier that your library card number, your user ID, and by default, password is the VVU123, and you may change later on. So Sriparna Ghosh already submitted his query through chat box. If we download PDF or some articles from the LS Discovery platform, will it be available to us offline?
So I think, librarian sir can answer this. I think this is something to do with the license agreement which you have with your publisher.
So almost questionnaire is over. May I request to the university librarian and Nimai Chansada, please. Nimai.
Okay, Dr. Saxena, for your very nice, to the point and useful presentation, I have no words to congratulate you, as you are the member of my family, as I told that.
Thank you,
you are the member of extended family member. So I don't want to congratulate you and pay thanks. Your duty you have carried out, my duty I am carrying out.
Thank
you, we
sir.
Are the passenger of same boat.
Yes,
to
sir,
offer
yes.
Our ready-made food for the academics fraternity to excel the research and academic activities. And this is one institute, I think you are working throughout the global level, ranging from India and outside India. So
yes.
It's very good, and it's your evergreen and ever active attitude to extend your support for the academics to excel the research and academic activities. And we sure will have no exception from your umbrella, cordial umbrella. So thank you for your support, and thank you for your presentation very nicely and briefly. And with your kind permission, I would like to just upload this video presentation in our library YouTube channel, so that you and myself will be less questioned. Whenever anyone asks, we can refer the video. You can consult and view the video to conceptualize the way of how to access LS Discovery, how to access JSTOR. There are many questions. Right now, one question, someone, Dipannita, has posted in the chat box, that said, can you please demonstrate the login procedure of LS Discovery? You please go through Live University website. We have already circulated the notice, most likely 7 to 10 days back. Okay, with that notice, there is an URL from your mobile device, from your desktop device, from your hostel to your residence, be it from Calcutta, be it from Bangladesh, be it from anywhere. You can use anywhere, any network, any device, that URL, lsdiscovery.ac.in, vbulsdiscovery.ac.in. So by using that, you can have login page, and with that login page, you need to give your library membership number, maybe vb/18123, like that, whatever it is. And password will be, for the first time entry, vbu123. VBU means Vishwa Bharati University, then ACT23123. All small case, there will be no space. After taking entry, you can go to your profile page and you can reset your password there by your own. So this is the simple way of taking entry in the LS Discovery. And someone is asking, how can I access JSTOR? See, the JSTOR, Springer, Sage, EBSCO, and many more, all the ebooks, all the e-journals, whatever we have procured, whatever we have ownership model, whatever we have subscription model, all those things, you can come with this LS Discovery login and you will be get it done. Because this LS Discovery by birth is a kind of remote access platform. So like earlier, you have just going to be confused yourself that like earlier Open Athens platform, you need to submit one undertaking format to me, which have been uploaded in our library website. Okay, but this time you do not need to submit any undertaking to me, because we are just make it more simpler than earlier. Whenever you fill up a form, and you will be getting a library smart card from Vishwabharati library, and with that library, you will be having your library card number and password, whatever I told, that is VBU123. Then you go to take entry there, and whenever you going to take, there will be a terms and condition page. And you need to have a check that I agree. So I am just copy and paste the main part of the undertaking portion. So once you agree with my terms and condition, it means that you will be downloaded anything, whatever purchased and subscribed by Vishwabharati Library Network will be downloaded for the use of academic and research activities by maintaining fair use doctrine, means to satisfy the copyright and patent right act, like that. And if you take any download unlimited, let's see, entire volume of a journal cannot be downloaded. It's very common thing. But one article from a issue, from a journal, is allowable. So you can do that thing, and you can take any chapter, any book downloaded, and for exam preparation, for dissertation preparation, for assignment preparation, for project preparation, for paper writing, for book writing, for thesis writing, you can freehand to use, provided you need to give full citation, full acknowledgement, called citation based on any international citation style. Then you need to give bibliography and reference. Reference at the end of the chapter, bibliography and the end of the book or the thesis, means all the chapters, to avoid any plagiarism issues. So that's all. So this LS Discovery means we are just going to give you, to me it is called home delivery food. It is a cooked food, just will be, you take entry by sitting in your house during this pandemic days as an alternative solution. My academic fraternity, to sort the academic fraternity, my library technical members, you might be aware the name Mr. Ramprasad Mojumdar, who is basically the backbone, basically the gem, basically the thinker, innovator of this backbone. It is his 24 hours labor output that, Nimaida, I need to cater my library service hassle-free to one and all of my Vishwarathi Library users through a single window. Can you support me? Then I just administrative extend my administrative support to him. And finally, he find out our beloved Lipsys Corporation, and with them, he is having a discussion last 3 to 6 months. Then finally, we are coming over here with this user-friendly and simple way of searching. So don't worry about that. If any question, I think you can post it to my colleague Ramprasad Mojumdar. That notice, his mail ID is there. Even the entire library website will be in this LS Discovery. So you can go with that. And in the left-hand panel about, under the about, you will get my team or our team. In our team, you will get all of my mail ID, all of my phone number. So there is no issue to make a contact with my library team. Now it's your duty how much food you will take and how the way you will accept my food like that. And see, the government is paying and spending money for you people. So it's our duty to use to the extent possible the resources we have purchased, the resources we have subscribed, the resources have been given free to different e-vendors. It's my duty, it's our duty to make it use more and more to inculcate the research activities. So please, those who are faculty members, share with the scholars and students. Those who are the scholars, please share with the friends. Those who are students, UG and PG, you can share with your friends. So it's very simple. Only your library membership card you need required. And you see, those who the first semester students, those who have their library card from Vishwarathi Library, since we are not issuing and returning any books to them, by this online platform, by sitting in their house, they now able to surf our resources. One of my student, Sim Sobhut Choudhury, most likely, if I'm not much wrong, he asked, I'm sure he is very serious students, Department of Physics, most likely, if I am not much wrong. He is a very good student and he's tried to take entry in LS Discovery and having some threats that it is not working like that. Susim, I assure you, and I just acknowledge your attitude that you have tried to take login there, but after 2-3 days, since my team member, this Lipsys team and my technical team, they are always working 24/7. So 1-2 days, I think it will be done. And I think today onwards, if you try, you will get something. At any point of time, if you will not get, don't be worried. Don't be frustrated. For the time, let us assume that our backend people is working with that. So after half an hour, after 1 hour, you can try. I think it will be resolved. And after first week of April, I think everything will be clear up before us like a signing done. Okay. So this is, and if I am not request my colleague, Mr. Ramprasad, I think Ramprasad is on the floor. Ramprasad, are you in the floor? Ramprasad?
Yes, Nimada.
Surjo Kumar, you are taking entry by Dr. Surjo Kumar.
Actually, by default, it was.
Oh, it is there. Yeah. So I think, may I now request my technical expert, who is basic, this is his glad day, pleasure day, happiness day to him, that every now and then, last 15 to 20 days, along with the Lipsys people, he is taking care from his house, Rampurhat, to there, and this Lipsys people from Calcutta, Delhi, and many more places, they are sitting there. What? So if I'm not requesting my colleague Ramprasad to say a few words for this, I think this demonstration program will not be a successful one and objectful. So please, Ramprasad, you say something. Then finally, Dr. Kaushik Ghosh will wrap up the session with a formal word of thanks. Thank you, Ramprasad, please.
Thank you, Nimaida. Thank you, Mr. Deepak Saxena ji. Thank you, Swamiranda. Actually, it was, I was attached with Lipsys from 1990 from Jadavpur University. In that time, today, I was a dream that there should be a platform in a single window, total resources. Last 2 or 3 or 6 years, we are using 2 or 3 platforms. Now, with the help of Lipsys and with the help of Vishwarathi University Authority, And with the help of our Nimaida, it is resolved to use the single interface for all the resources of the Vishwavarti universities and communication between the users and librarian. It will be the very easy to contact with the librarian, ask the question through LS Discovery. You can send the recommendation, you can put your reservation, you can donate your books through LS Discovery system. Everything is easy to users and librarian also. So thank you for the thank you to our university authority and especially to our librarian, Dr. Nimaichand Shah, who always helped me to save me that you go ahead. I am in your there. So thank you, Nimaida. It is my people, my team. And I just also thankful to our university and our authority. My sincere, I need the permission and approval. And also another thanks to the Deepak Saxena and his team.
Audio is not clear, Ram Prasad.
His team that, and Sundaranda.
Yes, yes. Actually, Swamiranda as good as salt of this food, because without salt, chicken, mutton, fish, egg, curry cannot be a competed one. So Swamiranda's role was like a salt and you are like a water. And basic cook was my colleague, Dr. Saxena. These three are the interrelated, interconnected, interdependent. Without you all, this cannot be possible. And finally, of course, as you told Ramda, the university authority and our e-resource selection committee, every member of our e-resource selection committee, we are really grateful to them. Without their unconditional support, unconditional cooperation, this was next to impossible to come this floor to discuss this, demonstrate LS Discovery. Please carry on, Ramda.
So,
Lipsis
manager, Mr. Deepak Saxena, kindly try and to make the access of Lipsis 10 and LS Discovery in the evening so that user can use the Lipsis and we are waiting. So many students are waiting for clearance and return the books and take the clearance certificate. So they are waiting for 2 days and 3 days. So try to release the Lipsis 10 first and then you can release the LS Discovery tomorrow also.
No, sir, we are trying basically, we updated the DNS. So your DNS updation takes some time.
Yes, yes.
So I think maybe it says 20 to 48 hours. So hopefully, maybe I think today evening or maybe sometime later night, I think it will be available.
Okay. Try to release the...
So we have set everything. Once the DNS is populated, it will be done. Yes. All technical work we have completed, only thing it's DNS configuration.
Both are passed already?
Yes, sir.
From first April, we can this way. Okay, thank you, Nimaida. Thank you, Dr. Saxena.
Okay, Kaushik, please.
Okay, actually, at the outset, this is the time for vote of thanks. I can say thank you, but it is not possible to complete the vote of thanks without mentioning a few names. So first of all, I convey thanks to the all distinguished participants who have attended this today's seminar as well as this series of special session also. So I also wish to express my gratitude to Saxena ji for your support and today's such kind of tremendous hands-on training as a special session. And the program could not have been organized without the leadership of our respected university librarian, Dr. Nimaichand Shah. I also convey my heart congratulations to you, Nimaida, please. So
thank you.
And at last but not least, I convey my hearty congratulations to my beloved colleague, Ram Prasad Majumdar, information scientist, And without his cooperation, this discovery service not have been materialized. Without his brainchild, without his energy, without his endless effort. So congratulations and thank you, Ramprasad. And I congratulate all the DVLN member, basically the team member of the technical and acquisition section, journal section, and all other team member. Their suggestion, without their suggestion, it is not possible to mature this LS discovery. And our Nimait already mentioned the e-resource selection committee, without their support, it is not possible to mature. And thanks to the our university authority, shown and at
all,
last
all in charge, Kaushik, all in charge of VVLN.
Sure, sure.
All in charge of
all the in charge, and I only mentioned the VVLN member. They are the member of the family. So all the in charge, I convey my thank you, and thank you all again. Thanks for coming. Have a nice day.